Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. So today is another episode of Shopping My Stash. I'm trying to be good this year. I haven't the Sephora sale got me. That's about what I've been trying to, other than that, I've been trying to be very good about using my products, but the Sephora sale got me. So I'm waiting for my order, and then you guys can see. And then I can show you guys what I got. I did a couple restocks of just the essential items, and then I bought a few skincare items, and only a couple makeup items. Not as much as I thought I would buy, because you guys, I always hit Rouge status by April. Not bragging, just saying. That's just how much, like, I would spend. But now that I'm, like, being very conscientious of what I bring into my collection, I'm not even, like, sure I'll hit Rouge status this year. But that's neither here nor there. Let's just take a look at what we used last week. So, we used the Becca Ultimate Coverage Complexion in Tobacco. I feel like we're almost done with this. Like, this is the old packaging. They went to just an all-glass packaging. But, like, I can't tell. It feels, though, like I'm almost done with it. I tried out this Too Faced Born This Way Concealer in Caramel. I like it. I use it to, like, highlight the high points of my face. You guys, this is my Hourglass Dim Light Ambient Lighting Powder. I use that for a finishing powder, and then I use the Milk Makeup Blur and Set Matte Loose Setting Powder in the shade Translucent Deep. I used this for a week. I did not notice, because I had done a full face base of Milk foundation, primer, and powder, and then I used, like, the sticks and everything, and I had gotten an allergic reaction. Couldn't tell you what did it, so I'm trying to use them separate to see what it is that is bringing out that allergic reaction. I'm just opening my drawers to put stuff back in here. So, yeah, that's what I can tell you. I bought this L'Oreal lip product. So I was jonesing for the MAC one, and I bought this L'Oreal Color Riche Shine in the color 900. I like it. It's good. I used it for, like, a whole week, and then I used it again for another whole week, so clearly I enjoyed it. The Viseart, what is this? It's the Viseart, I think it's the Milieu palette is what it's called. Neutral Matte Eyeshadow Palette. But I think this is the Milieu. It doesn't have the name on it, but I'm pretty sure this is the Milieu one with a pink. I used it in collaboration with this Girl Meets Makeup Cosmos palette. It doesn't have, this palette is good. Like, the shimmers are really nice. It only has three mattes, and it's this deep dark purple over here, this pink right there, and that green up this, like, you can't tell, but it's like a tealy green. Those are the only three mattes in that palette. And I needed, like, a neutral, like, I know it's a colorful palette, but I needed something else. Like, I feel like it needs one more matte in there, because it won't stay open. But okay, you guys, let me show you this. Okay, so this is a deep dark purple matte, hot pink, and then there's this color right here. Like, I love the mattes, don't get me wrong, but I mean, what can you do with all this color, with all those colorful shimmers? Okay, so look at this. So that's what you have to work with for matte. So yeah, I had to bring in a few other shades to help me out to do looks. So yeah, I liked this palette. It's an indie brand. guys have heard of it, Girl Meets Makeup. They have a few other palettes. I bought 4 of their palettes. And I'm, so far I'm enjoying it. They have the Fall Leaves, Cosmos, Rosie. And which other one do I have? I think I have another one. I can't remember what it's called, but I think it starts with a G. Gloomy. That's what I have. Gloomy. But they have others too. And they do like a set where you get 4 for like $100. And then during a certain time you can get it for like cheaper. That's how I ended up getting it. But I like it. Very pigmented. I didn't notice like a lot of fallout. Which is good. Because I went in on it. And then I liked it. I mean, that's all I can tell you guys. I liked it a lot. So, yeah. The Josie Maran Argan Black Oil Mascara. Not my favorite. I hate the brush. Like, I hate the whole formula. It's not, like, my favorite. Like, I don't like using the word hate, but I don't really like it. The Milk Kush Mascara. I don't like this mascara either. I'm like, I used this mascara when I used the full face of Milk stuff, and I don't really care for this mascara. I found that my mascara was like always flaking on me, and I feel like this is on the days I use that. Dior Show. This is the Dior Show Art Pen in Catwalk Black. This is the brush tip is beautiful, but I mean, I guess it works now that it's been laying down on its side. I don't know if it's the blackest black. I think it's like $30 for this. You can get the same result with cheaper. That's just it. I haven't used my Bobbi Brown in a while, but, and then, this is the Essence Superlast Eyeliner. I like this eyeliner, I just don't like how long this this thing is. I feel like they need to cut it in half, and I would like it so much better. I might even cut it in half myself. I gotta remember to do that. Like, cut it so it's not so long. Because I have a harder time with it when it's so long. What is this? Billion Dollar Brow Universal Brow Pencil. It's garbage. Like, I'm going to only be able to use this when I'm doing, like, no makeup days. Like, look at this. It's like a gray tone. So it's going to be for one of those, again, no makeup days. I started using this because I finished the Benefit Brow Goof Proof in number 5, and I was using that. And it just makes my brows look like I don't have any brows on. So I'm like, okay, that's more of a no makeup look day. So yeah, that's it. This is the Sephora lip gloss. It's a lip honey colorful gloss. It doesn't really have any color, but it's really nice and shiny. So I liked that. This is in the shade, this is in Wildflower. I don't think, like, if you're my skin tone or deeper, and I wear a Fenty 385, I don't think you'll notice any color. If you're medium toned or lighter, you might notice like this like brownie tinge on your skin. I use this Too Faced Lip Injection Extreme Instant and Long Term Lip Plumper just as a primer for my lips, just for primer, and I liked it. Like, I actually enjoy it. I don't know if it actually plumps my lips, because I don't tend to notice a difference, but I like it to, it gives my lips, like, a smooth surface to work with, so I liked that. This I picked up in the Sephora sale, because Sephora collection is 30% off, and it's the Sephora, what is it? Sephora, I can't read this. Sephora Colorful Ombre Papyrus Crayon Shadow and Liner. It's waterproof. It's in the shade Secret Boudoir. So I use it in my inner waterline, and I liked it. So that's a sneak peek of what I picked up. This is one of the non-essential things that I picked up. 30% off of the Sephora collection. Enjoyed it. I'm going to continue to use that in my inner waterline. NARS Taj Mahal. You guys, this is like a staple in my summer collection. Oh, I know what I forgot to pick up. Okay. And then this is the Taraji Glow. From MAC. You guys, do you notice how much I've used? Like, the dome is gone. It's, like, flat, and I'm loving it. I thought for sure I would, because I was using the Josie Maran in, along with the, what is it, the Becca. I thought for sure I would finish this, but I didn't. But I'm still making good progress. I'm halfway through the bottle. It's the Josie Maran Argan Moonstone Drops. I use this as a primer because it is a makeup priming and highlighting oil. So I use it as a primer. It gives me a nice soft glow. Like it. I picked this up right before the sale. I could have waited to the sale, but I used it for like a week or two. This is the Hollywood Flawless Filter in 6.5 from Charlotte Tilbury. I actually enjoyed this a lot. I did not use it this week, which shockingly, I thought for sure I would use it like in addition to the Josie Maran. And I was just like, the Josie Maran was just perfect enough for my skin. Alright, Fenty Beauty Full Frontal Mascara in Cause I'm Black. I actually enjoy this a lot. I actually enjoyed that a lot. My LYS No Limits Matte Bronzer in Strength. This is the dark one. I was using this too when I had that allergic reaction. I thought for sure this was, like, I didn't know for sure what was it. So I, again, broke up all the products and used them separately. Didn't have the same issue. So I am continuing to use that, and I continue to enjoy it. It's like $18. It's great. Here we are with the NARS Medium 2 Caramel Soft Matte Complete Coverage Concealer. Look, you guys, you can see, like, just how much I've used. This is like you just looking into the bottom of the pan. Isn't that just gorgeous when you can see, like, the end of the pan? Anyway, I use this for an eye primer. I enjoy it that way. I also enjoy it as a, concealer itself too, so that's great. And then the Billion Dollar brow gel. I like this brow gel. I don't like the pencil, but I like the brow gel. So that is all I use this week, and I am actually enjoying shopping my stash and adding just a few just a few items into my collection, because it just it's showing me what I like versus what I don't like. And what I wanted to, like, see leave my collection. So, I'm going over here now to pick out this week's products. I'm sorry, you guys. My brain is just, like, apparently not working for me. She's just on a whole different level. So, up here, as you guys can see, I have the, a few eyeshadow palettes. I bought this last October when Mama Mitchell launched his own brand. This is the Head in the Cloud. It's still in the box. You guys, this was the worst experience for a launch that I've ever gone through. And I've gone through some pretty bad launches. But this was actually, I think, to date, my worst. So I just set it aside and never used it. So I'm going to I'm gonna pick it up right now. I'm gonna just set it down so you guys can. I'll take it out of the box so you guys can see what it looks like. So this is what the box looks like. Beautiful packaging. Not gonna lie. Gotta give credit where credit is due. Beautiful packaging. Like, beautiful packaging. It also comes with like a makeup bag that fits the palette. Okay. So the palette, this is the outside of the palette. Looks just like the box. And then open it up. Okay. Let me try opening it up without dropping it. So this is the inside of that palette. Like, look how gorgeous it is. I just got so like annoyed with just how I ordered my product on, I think I ordered it launch day, so it was like October something. It took almost a month to ship, and I literally didn't get any. I got one email confirming that it, I think I got one email confirming my order place, and that was it. And I just like, I bought both palettes that he had at the time, and I think the whole launch experience just turned me off, and I literally just put it away. And I'm gonna use it because I already spent the money, and I'm just gonna see how I like the product. Okay, so I'm gonna grab a couple of lip glosses. You guys, I don't need another nude lip gloss ever. Let me repeat that for you. I do not need another nude lip gloss ever. Because all these right here are all the Dose of Colors lip glosses. I bought them when they were buy one, get one free. So I'm just going to do a little thing here. So I'm going to do this one. It's called On Repeat. And then I'm going to do, well, that's Tough Cookie. And then I'm going to do Don't Be Chai. And then I also want to do this NARS, what is this? It's the NARS, oh shit, I can't read this. It's NARS something, Oil Infused Lip Tint in Orgasm. Okay, so we're going to do that. And then I think I want to use, let's pull this out of here. I want to pull out one of my Sephora lip clicks or whatever they're calling them. Yeah, it's the melting lip clicks, and this one is in the shade Creme Brulee. So we're going to use that. And I think that should do it. Because, oh, let's see if I can get any use out of my Tom Ford this week. Because I'm on a mission to use this Tom Ford Sultry before it goes bad. This is what that looks like. So, on a mission to use it before it goes bad. It smells pretty decent right now. So, we're doing that. So, I got 5 lip products in there. So, that should work out really well for me. And then, okay. So I'm trying not to buy any nude lip products, any new nude lip products. Okay, let's go into the drawers. I feel like I need a highlighter. Like, I don't feel like I need a highlighter. I know I need a highlighter. Okay, this is my highlighter drawer, you guys. I've tried to declutter this drawer. And I only was able to give up one. You heard me right. I was only able to give up one highlighter out of this whole drawer. I'm like, highlighter is my favorite. And I just couldn't do it. And I feel so ashamed. But you know what? I spent my money on this. So if I can't get rid of them, that's fine. Like, you guys, if you can't get rid of stuff when you're trying to, like, declutter and you've paid for it, it's because you can't part with your money. And that's fine. And it's a powder product. So I'm going to hold on to it and just keep it in my heart for now. Okay. So I'm going to use this Becca highlighter in Royal Flush. I don't even have to open it or look at the back of it to know what it's called. Yep, Royal Glow. I'm sorry, not Flush. Royal Glow. See how pretty that is? Yeah. This was released for the royal wedding of Meghan Markle. Well, for Meghan Markle and Prince Harry. Oh, actually, no, you know what? I'm looking over here. I have this I Need a Nude Glow from Natasha Denona that I haven't used yet. Bought it in the last Sephora sale and forgot I had it. Okay, so let's go ahead and use that. I didn't forget I had it, but I just put it away. Okay, so yeah, that's what that looks like. Isn't she beautiful? Okay, that's what we're gonna use. Sorry if you guys can hear that. I think that's my neighbor opening the garage door with no consideration for me. My windows are open so you can hear the neighborhood. That's what it is. My windows are open, so you most definitely can hear the neighborhood. Alright, so we want to use a blush. Sorry, I'm sitting down, you guys. So we want to use a blush, and we want to use something we haven't used in a while, which pretty much could be anything, to be honest. Let's go ahead and use the, so, I'm going to use this, okay, so here's the deal. I'm going to repurpose something. So I have this MAC Strange New Worlds Trip the Light Fantastic Powder. So this is what it looks like. It came out with a Star Wars collection. So when I swatch it, it has a little bit more pigmentation than I would like to use on my cheeks as a highlighter. So I'm going to repurpose this and see how it goes as a blush. It might be a little bit too light, but I feel like with MAC blushes, you can, or with MAC products, you can build them up. So I'm going to repurpose this and see how I like it as a highlighter, or as a blush instead of a highlighter. All right, so then I need a bronzer. And I decided that I'm going to use my bronzer in Delphic. That's like my favorite, and it's from MAC. So MAC only releases this bronzer during the summer, and I feel like they should have, this is one of their bronzers that they should have year round. Like, look how gorgeous it is. Okay, so that's what I'm going to use. And I think that's it out of this drawer. I don't need any more lip products or any small, any shadows out of here, but I'm going to put back this shadow here. I think it's the Miliu palette, if I'm not lying. You guys, I'm so proud of myself right now. I literally was gonna buy the Huda Beauty, the new Huda Beauty palettes, the brown ones, and then I was like, hold on, you really are only buying this palette because A, you want the really shimmery colors, but guess what, you just bought a whole bunch of Cleona stuff. And you bought a bunch of MAC ones, or you got a bunch of MAC ones, you don't need it. And I actually stood my ground and stood firm and did not buy it. So, praise be to me. Ooh, I have two new hashes. Okay, so I did, and I showed you guys what I got in the CCO. Plus, I got this at the CCO, these Put On The Gold Shiny Eyeshadows. So I definitely don't need it. Okay, what I'm going to do, though, is I'm going to grab Well, let me look at this palette one more time. See if I truly need... No, I don't need any additional shadow because I can figure it out. I have like 25 shades in here. I can figure it out. So I don't think I need anything out of here. I want to try using some false lashes. I mean, I run the potential of gluing my eyes shut, but, you know, we learn. So I'm going to grab this, Velour Lash & Go. It's the eyeliner and lash, Velour Lash & Go Eyeliner and Lash Adhesive Hybrid. I got this at Sephora. Anyway, so I got this, Velour Lash & Go, hybrid at Sephora. So I'm going to give that a shot and I'm going to start practicing. I got to get a chair. Sit. My legs are starting to hurt. Okay. So I'm going to try and, use that, or practice using that for lashes. Yep. I got plenty of lashes I can practice on. I have... Okay, so then I'm going to practice using lashes, and I think I can use this. I do have a pair of lashes out there, but I'm just going to grab another pair just in case I can't figure it out, because I don't want to futz around too much. Okay, so I'm going to use this. I'm gonna use this ColourPop Falsies lashes in Minx. That's what she looks like. You guys, it could either go really well or this could go really bad. Okay. And then I'm gonna pick out, because my mascara, as you guys know, my mascara collection is quite extensive right now. I am going to grab, I have the Josie Maran mascara again, and I literally, like I just said, I don't really care for that mascara. So what I'm going to do, because when you buy certain things online, like if you go on QVC and you buy like a set, sometimes they have like the mascara and other products in there. So that's how I ended up doing it, and I was on like an auto, whatever. I have two of them, don't worry. I'm gonna get rid of one because I don't care for it, and maybe like on my next go around I'll care for it a little bit more. I'm gonna hold on to the Milk Makeup one and give it a shot, like try to give it some more shots and see if maybe I like it. Maybe I'll hold on to the Josie Maran one and come back to it at a later day. But I want to use, I got like 8 million things back here. I'm going to use this Mana Kadar Beauty Bloom Volumizing Mascara in Jet Black. It's by, it's by Mana Kadar Beauty. I got this in a BoxyCharm, so we'll see how that goes. That'll be the one I add. Plus my false lash effect mascara. I like to use that as a primer for other mascaras. I got shit going on back here too. For somebody who doesn't wear false lashes, I sure have a lot of false lashes. Sure do have a lot of false lashes. And I don't even like wearing false lashes. Anyway, that's neither here nor there. Okay, let's pick out a brow product, because the brow product I use, as you guys heard, did not do me well. So we are going to use this Urban Decay Brow Blade in Neutral Nana. Well, it's see how that goes. And then I also have the Benefit Gimme Brow in number 5. So I'm going to use one of those because I have two of those. I've got 4, I've got 5, and I've got I got 2 5s, so I can use one. Alright. So, yeah. That's where she's going right there. And then we're going to put the ABH stuff in here. Let's just grab this brow stuff. And then, last drawer, I'm going to grab some concealer. Okay. Alright. So, we are going to grab the... We're going to use the Bobbi Brown Instant Full Coverage Concealer in Warm Honey. Can you guys see it? This is the Bobbi Brown Instant Full Coverage Concealer in Warm Honey. And then for primer this week, I'm going to go ahead and use my e.l.f. Putty Primer. And for face primer, ooh, dang girl, you almost forgot face primer. For face primer, let's try the Milk Hydro Grip Primer by itself to see if this is what was breaking me out. And then we are going to use the, I want to use this Morphe and Jeffree Star Set and Refresh Mix in the Starberry Scent. I think I have my Kat Von D over here. I feel like she's almost finished. This one is the Fresh, it's a glow water. It's not really a setting spray, but I use it in addition to this Kat Von D. I don't know if the Kat Von D will leak if I put it on its side like this. Well, we'll just set it up there so we don't run the risk. Okay, so yeah, we're going to go ahead and do that. Whoop, whoop-a, almost fell. And then we are going to put the Charlotte Tilbury in the drawer for the primers. Alrighty, and so you guys, sorry guys, I'm trying to move stuff out of the way. Okay, so I have the ColourPop Glisten Up Illuminating Mist if I don't like the Starberry one from Jeffree Star in there, and Morphe. Oh, I need foundation. You guys, if my head wasn't attached to my bodies, I tell ya. Okay, so I want to finish up this Rodan and Fields in Espresso number 6. I think at the time I did this, this was the deepest shade they had. And then I'm going to use this Beauty Balm from Dr. Jart. It's a Dr. Jart Premium Beauty Balm Multi-Action Skincare Makeup in the shade Deep, which is not very... So I'm going to use that. So those will be my two products. This is really light and this is really deep. So mix them together. You can see my drink. Mix them together and that's actually the best shade match that I can come up with. I was going to use the Bobbi Brown, but then I was like, we'll do like another time. All right. So then for powder, we are going to use this is why I don't need to buy any more powders because I've got enough. We're going to use this medium dark Bare Minerals original powder. This is what she looks like. So that's going to be what we use. Alright, so we're going to put this to the side over there. We're going to put the hourglass back for the finishing powder, because I like to use that as a finishing powder. And we're going to pick up our Guerlain Meteorites Electric Pearl in, I think this is golden? It doesn't say. It doesn't say what it's called, but I think, so this is what she looks like. Ooh, very fragrant with perfumey. So that's what we're going to use to finish up our face. If you look in the bottom of mine, it's like the balls are all broken up in the bottom, which is fine. That's what you want. Yeah, so... So that's it, I think. I just have to actually put stuff away. Okay, so here we go. Setting powder, finishing powder, foundations. I have my SPF up here and my C. Kaper Camo Drops from Dr. Jart that I use sometimes. I use the I'm starting to go back to using my SPF every day. Setting spray from Morphe and Jeffree Star, no longer available because they cut all ties. Milk Hydro Grip Primer. Concealer from Bobbi Brown. I think that, my eye primer, the Elf Putty Primer. I like that, actually. And my two mascaras that I will be using this week are the Manic Adar and the Lash Princess from whatever they're from. Essence is the Lash Princess and the Manic Adar one is Manic Adar. This would be my eyelash glue and my fake lashes, and these are my lashes that I have out here. I don't even remember what brand they're from, but we'll figure it out, I'm sure. And my brows, my brow products, can go on with my concealer. And then my... I gotta put away my Elias bronzer real quick. Okay, so then my MAC product that I'm going to be using as a blush goes right in here. It'll probably just be looking like a natural flush. Delphic bronzer. I'm going to be using the Natasha Denona I Need a Nude highlighter, finally. And then my Made by Mitchell, Mitchell. Oh, actually, no, it just says Made by Mitchell on here. Head in the Clouds palette. It says on the back, let me read it. Hello, my fellow dreamers. I just wanted to say thank you for joining me on this journey. This truly means the world to me, and I owe all of this to you. I have always been told to keep my feet on the ground and have my head in the clouds. It's got me this far in life, and I believe it can make your wildest dream a beautiful reality to open your heart and stand your feet. No, and stand your ground. Have empathy and know you are still number one. Blend without fear, but don't blend in. Keep dreaming, baby. The world is yours. So, Head in the Cloud Pressed Pigment Palette. Okay. So, that's what she looks like. I really actually enjoy this whole palette just gives me summer vibes. But, like I said, I didn't use it because I was just so annoyed with the whole launch thing, and I'm just like, ugh. Now I'm just gonna use it. Let's hope it fits. Oh, and it fits. And it fits. Let's just go ahead and put that in there. And we're gonna put away our lip products. So we've got Dose of Colors on repeat. Dose of Colors, Don't Be Chai. NARS Orgasm. Tom Ford Sultry. And Sephora Collection Melting Lip Click in Creme Brulee. Well, she's going to have to lay down in front here, I guess. I'm going to put my... Actually, I have this... hold on. Because I usually use this. But I'm going to use this one in Tangerine. I think is what it's called. Tangerine Dream from... It's a Too Faced lip injection in Tangerine Dream. I'm going to use that as my... lip primer that I like to do. And then for liner, I'm gonna try. Okay. You guys, I forgot to try a liner just in case I don't like the Velour Lash one as a whatever. I already have. I'm gonna put this down here. How long do these lash glue last? I don't like the smell of this, because I've opened it and left it. Ugh. I don't know. It looks weird to me. I might just toss this. Alright, so I'm going to go ahead and toss that. I might just run over to Ulta and get... Because I don't remember. I think I opened it, like, maybe 2 years ago. And... I'm too worried about that now to, like, do that now. Okay, so for lash is, I'm going to use, for liner, I'm going to use this Sephora Collection in my inner waterline. It's waterproof, what the hell is this? Summer Circus. It's a shimmer. Well, that ought to be interesting. And then I'm going to grab... Black lace. That's another one. That's a pen. Okay, so I'm just gonna grab one of my Stila liquid eyeliner. So I'm gonna grab this one. It's a Stila liquid eyeliner in it's the black one. It's a Stay All Day liquid eyeliner, and I'm gonna use the shimmer eyeliner. See how we get along. And just put it up here with my mascara. I'm just gonna use those, see how I like them, and then I'm just gonna put these back because I already know I like them. That one's not my favorite, but she'll do in a pinch. Okay. Do I want to grab a lip liner? I don't really line my lips. That's why I don't buy lip liners, because I don't line my lips enough to warrant a lip liner. But I'm going to use MAC Chestnut. That's what she looks like right here. So we're going to grab a lip liner and just set her up here. And yeah, that's it, you guys. That's my whole Shop My Stash collection going on here. And that's what we're doing for the week. So anyway, you guys, thank you so much for stopping by and watching this video. I know it's a little bit long because I go over products that I use. I talk about it a little bit. And I also ramble on. But, you know, we're all friends here. We all talk about the makeup that we like. So thank you so much. And have a great day. Bye.